everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, you're most definitely welcome. And if you're an old subscriber or you've watched some of my videos before and you're back here, you're most definitely welcome. So hope you guys are fine. Hope you're staying safe, you're staying at home, hope you're taking your vitamins, drinking water, trying to stay healthy, you know. Hope your family, they're doing well. I hope this pandemic hasn't hit close to your family, or if it has, just stay strong, you know. So yeah, welcome to my channel. So in today's video, it's not really going to be long. I just want to make a very brief update about my life. You know, it's kind of been a while I've been on here, and I keep apologizing, but just bear with me. I'm going to make videos as much as I can. That's what I'm going to do. So if you would love to listen to today's video, definitely keep watching. I never made it, but I know what it takes. I'm motivated by a mix of emotion. Got my statement and I'm reading it slow so I can understand it fully. Because today, April 30th, marks the last day of my internship in med school. So today is day 365 out of 365. Whoop, whoop, whoop. So you can now officially call me MD. Like, put some respect on my name, okay? Okay? So if you're following me so well, I think the last update I made was about my psychiatric rotation. But after that, I had OB-GYN and I had pediatrics. And this month, I was supposed to have internal medicine too. So I would say that my OB-GYN and my pediatrics rotation were the best. They were also the most stressful. But they were the best. I kind of found a bit of fulfillment in them. Even when I was like really tired, struggling, hungry till midnight, I really didn't care. I just wanted to be there for my patients. Do you understand? So I think they were it was the best 4 months for me, because OB-GYN and pediatrics are major rotations. So we rotate in them for 2 months each. IM as well is a major rotation, but if you follow my videos, it was my first rotation, so I had IM1, so I was supposed to end this month with IM2. OB-GYN and pediatric were so lovely, you know. In OB-GYN, I remembered one of my patients who had APAS. She was the best. I will never forget her. Like, if you don't know what APAS is, it's like a blood condition whereby blood clots form in unnecessary places, and it's not really a good thing. And she's had several pregnancy losses, but this particular pregnancy she made it through, so I was so happy for her. Even after the baby came, I was like, "Mom, is it okay I take a picture with the baby?" I did. She gave me a gift. She was like, "Thank you for being a blessing, for standing by me, everything." It was so fulfilling. As well, in my pediatric rotation, there was one baby I kind of like got attached to, kinda. And then when it was my last day in the department, the mother was like, "Oh, thank you for being there for my child," because I was always there monitoring the child, checking up on the child. She held my hand. She was like, "Thank you, doctora." That's what we're called, like the female doctors are called here in the Philippines, doctora. I don't know why, but yeah. She was like, "Thank you so much, doki." Or sometimes they call you doki, doctora. "Thank you so much. What you did mean a lot to me." So it was those little little moments, you know, that really gave me joy. You know, to the extent that when I even finished board rotations, I was confused as to which I might probably specialize in. But to be honest, I really have love for kids. I just hate to see them sick, you know, I just hate it. And one of the reasons why I might really not go for OB-GYN is because if you go for obstetrics and gynecology, you would also have to do surgeries. And if you follow my last video, you would know when I said that I really don't like surgery. It's an interesting thing, yeah, but I really don't like surgery. So that would be one of the biggest reasons why I might not be an OB-GYN, even if I really love the specialty. So my specialty could probably be pedia. It's gearing towards pediatrics, or like I said in my other video, probably family medicine. But we'll see, you know, life is life, you know, you just put it in the hands of God and you keep going. So an update about my internship. I am supposed to finish today. This is the 30th. I'm recording this video on the 30th of April 2020, which is supposed to be 365 days of my internship, because we started May 1st, 2019. So I'm supposed to end this month with internal medicine too, yeah. But because of this COVID-19, we've been on lockdown. All interns were pulled out from the hospital. I think number one, even though we are interns and we are health workers, we are still students. That's the reality, and they don't really pay us, and you know. So, and then if majority of us get sick, like, who's going to pay the bills? Something like that. I really don't know the. But it's just for safety purposes. So we were told to stay at home. So since last month, March 15th, till today, April 30th, we've been at home, not really in the hospital. So what have we been doing at home? Schools came up with programs for interns, and they were supposed to come up with programs for first year to third year medical students, but there's been a hiccup. Like, some don't have good internet and everything. And then SHED, which is the Commission for Higher Education. I really don't know the full list, I'm just going to check. So SHED was like, okay, so they're going to just cancel the online classes for first year to third year, because they don't want a situation where people will be still going to the cyber cafes. So what's the use of the whole lockdown and stay at home? So it's going to be forfeited. So they cancelled that. But for fourth year interns, we still went on with the online classes. So some schools do like lectures through Zoom. My school had another approach. We had another website where we had reading materials and study materials, study videos. And then we've written like series of exams. So you might want to ask me, so what happens now? Because it's more like we're not in the hospital for 1 month and 15 days to fulfill our requirement. The APMC, which is the Association for Philippine Medical Colleges, I guess, they opted for us to do online classes, and then it would just be credited. And there's wisdom in that, because out of the 12 months we're supposed to rotate, at least we did about 10 and a half to 11, so it's not really much of a gap, because even the departments we're missing, we've actually done maybe one part of it or so. But then there was a clause in their statement which also said that we probably might be going back to the hospital, maybe a little extension, because the coronavirus affected everybody. So there might be a little extension, in the sense that major rotations are OB-GYN, pediatrics, surgery, and internal medicine. So maybe those that are lacking a month might still go back to fulfill that. So the truth is, nothing is certain yet, but in the real calendar, I am an MD already. I'm supposed to graduate now. But if we don't go back to the hospital, and our online classes and lectures, which were told to us that would be credited, then that's totally fine. But yeah, So yeah, this is me. I can't believe that the journey, I wouldn't say the journey has ended, but this stage of the journey has ended, and I'm really grateful to God for it. Like, who would have thought that I, Wincywhitewinna Orisha Wuvemi, will be seated here right now and will be called MD medical. Oh, like, God is too good, guys. Like, fam, God is good. God is really good. If you're planning to study medicine, you can do it. You can actually do it. Just put your mind to it. Just do what you have to do. Okay, you can really do it. So right now, some of you might want to ask, what next? To be fair, I really don't know what's next, because we still have the lockdown till May 15th here in the Philippines, in Cebu, where I am. We still have the lockdown till May 15th. So if it's postponed, or sorry, if the lockdown is extended again or cancelled, I don't know, that's what depends what's next. But so far, I'm just hoping that the next thing will be graduation and then processing our diploma and TOR. So yeah, that'll be it. I don't really know if we're going to have a physical graduation, you know, nothing is certain. But yeah, I just wanted to come here, you know, and share my joy with you guys, because you've been with me throughout the journey. You know, when I, even days that I complain about my rotation, complain about my patients, you know. So yeah, so I also want to use this medium, or this media, to really thank all those that were part of my journey. You know, you cannot really make it to the end alone. I want to thank God for my mom and my dad, who were very supportive financially, and also in terms of like always being there, encouraging me. I want to thank my girlfriends in college, my Nigerian girlfriends, and my other friends, Doris, Judy, Blessing, Fatima, Chelsea. Like, you girl are the best. Oh, I'm not Naya. I want to thank God for you girls in my life. You know, we kept motivating each other and keep telling ourselves, like, we know if we go Ninja, MT, and Dedo, we dey carry our degree, they go. Like, those are the kind of friends you want. I want to thank God for my boyfriend as well. Yeah, woo. He's been like extremely supportive. It's not easy to date a medical student, I'm telling you. So if you want to date a medical student, you have to be really strong. And that was my boyfriend for me. I want to thank my group mates, group 2, batch Axon, group Tolo, group Totoy, group Tolong. Like, they've been amazing, also supporting me. And I really want to thank my entire batch Axon. They made me the class president, and to be honest, it's really not easy leading 136 students. Like, it's stressful, it's way up there, even when majority of them are like older than you. But these people are like so supportive, so humble to help me lead them. And yeah, I just, you know, it's a miracle. I just want to thank you all. Yeah, so that's it. That's just the brief update. I don't want to go here and there and make this video long. For you, my followers or subscribers, and those who've watched my videos, who have sent me messages on my Gmail, I see your messages, promise. I really see your messages. So now that I'm a bit done with internship, looking forward to the future, I'm going to be doing one or two videos. I'm going to be doing a series of videos. So if you really want to know like some things about schooling in the Philippines, maybe as a Nigerian or other foreign student, if you want to know what my experiences were, you know, just leave ideas of videos down in the comment section, and I will try my best to make those videos, because right now I'm a bit free. Yeah. So I'm a bit free, so I think I can do those videos, do my research for you, ask questions for the ones I don't know, because we don't know everything, and I'm waiting for you. So yeah, so yes, it's been a wonderful journey. I'm now an MD. Oh my God, like, you can just wake up in the morning and your life can just change forever. Like, fam, Yeah, God is so good. I'm so happy. Please, I just want you all watching this video to just take a minute to thank God for my life, because God is so good. Like, you all don't know the story. Maybe in one of my videos I'm going to tell the story of my academic journey. Yeah, it might not make sense to some people, but it's one of the big testimonies of my life, and I think I'm going to make it. So yeah, MD. So if you have not subscribed to this channel, tell me, what are you doing? I judge you. You are judged. What are you doing? Click on it. Where is it? It's Shade, that red thing. You click on it, okay? And you like this video and you share with your loved ones. Okay, so until my next video.